Drew and T are back in the van, driving north for 3.5 hours to just outside Newcastle Upon Tyne. They're visiting an architectural salvage yard who've recently branched out into antiques. The company's well known in the industry, and Drew's keen to pay his first visit.
We're meeting two brothers. They've just taken over the business a couple of years ago. O'Brien's has been in the demolition and architectural salvage trade for at least 30 years that I know of. Big outfit, really big outfit, but mainly slates and tiles and slab, bricks.
Right.
So I've never been there.
Newcastle sits on the River Tyne. The city boomed during the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century through coal mining and shipbuilding. The medieval castle built by William the Conqueror's son gave the city its name and is one of the most complete surviving Norman keeps in England. O'Brien Architectural Salvage is a 20-minute drive from the city. They started trading from their 13-acre site in 1973. Brothers Ryan and Craig Williams manage the architectural salvage side of the site.
We started off with slates, tiles, and then we progressed into reclaimed flooring. And then from then on, we've gone into garden furniture and antiques, bits and bobs, just a bit of everything really now.
We've got a lot more stuff now. Everyone comes in and just seems to think it's really good. Everyone kind of gets lost in it.
I'm looking forward to it. It'll be a good deal, obviously fun, a bit of haggling, but it should be a fun day.
Blimey, that's a big one. Is that available?
Yeah.
How many have you got?
That's the last one left. We sold the rest. We just haven't put it out on the wall yet.
What a fantastic find. Just walked in and there's a huge Gents of Leicester industrial railway type clock right in front of me. People call them railway clocks because they're generally found in railway stations and they're big, so right down a platform you can see them.
This large clock dates from the 1930s. Established in 1872, Gents of Leicester were a major manufacturer of clocks and other electrical equipment for over a century. Once restored, it could be worth around £800.
What do you want for it? £350?
£400.
£375? Got to be tough on you because I've got work here.
Go on then.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
What a whopper.
Should turn it, shouldn't it, actually?
Clocks like that are very, very desirable and they will always sell and people always want one. They're just one of those things, they never go out of fashion.
See, it's always the stuff in the back room, isn't it?
The boys take Drew and T over to the original salvage yard.
Let's start off in this room here.
Oh, hello.
Quite a lot of lights and some lights up on the top. I don't know if they're an interest.
We're in a sort of garagey bit of the yard and there's these great big explosion-proof or sort of gas-proof lights. You'd find them in mines and in spray booths and in factories where they had your sort of incendiary things. And they're pretty damn cool. They're good, but there's a problem. The problem is with them is they're really, really, really heavy. So for somebody to hang that, it's a bit of an issue, you know? I think they're from the sort of 50s. Early 50s, I'd say. These will end up probably in a bar, and we've had some success selling large runs of them to fashion labels as well.
These cast-iron industrial lights were made by British-based company GEC. They have an airtight seal to prevent any combustible materials from entering the lights and igniting, causing an explosion. Cleaned and rewired, they could be worth around £150 each.
What will you take each?
I would have to speak maybe with the directors just to see.
Okay.
And see if it is something that he's definitely going to be willing to sell.
Okay.
I don't know if you can put an offer and I can go to him.
They're rough and they need work. £35 each.
£35 each.
Right, I'll ask him.
He's offering £35 each.
These lamps are not rare. I've already got a ton of them, but I'll buy them because they all match. There's a run. £35 each is all I'm prepared to pay, so I've gone in at one bid. I'm not going to pay a pound more. What'd they say?
Yeah, that's not a problem.
They'll do a deal?
Yeah. Yeah.
Marvellous.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Don't know how many there is there, T. You've got a busy day today, you have.
the following day, they're back in North Wales with a full vanload of items for restoration.
Hello, 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 hello. Carl, yeah. Hope you had your Brave tablets. You know what's involved with these, don't you?
Yeah.
You got to split them.
Yeah.
They're a nightmare, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Carl makes a start on the first of the 14 industrial lights. The trickiest part will be splitting the seal.
There's no... Oh, that was nice. Did you hear that? Somebody's had it apart and the seal's already been cracked. Less work for me to do.
So with that positive result, Carl can move straight on to replacing the original light fitting. And as the light weighs around 15 kilograms, Carl adds a strong sealing mount before reassembling it.
All right, dude, I'll let you have that one. That's quite a nice light.